And the Buddha taught at different levels, depending on the degree of understanding of his audience. He said it was like the shelving of the sea at the seashore. You can go down, walking into the sea, getting slowly deeper and deeper. You can go up to your knees, you can go up to the middle, you're up to here, if you want to. It's your choice how deep you want to go into the sea. Similarly, these teachings can be taken at different levels. Sometimes people say the Buddha taught at three levels. The first was to teach us how to live a happier life in the here and now. The second is how to lay down the causes which will lead to a happy birth in the next or subsequent lives. And the third was to enable us to attain the state of enlightenment, which is the ultimate goal. That brings to an end the cycle of birth and death, birth and death, birth and death. So if the Buddha had only taught at the first level, then that Buddhism would be nothing more than just one more therapy for helping people to get over their present problems. But his ultimate aim is this state of enlightenment. So if we start working our way through this path, you can see it's subdivided into three groups. One is called Panya, another is Sila, and the last one is Samadhi. And this is the way in which classically the Eightfold Path is taught. This is something which I don't think the Buddha had this classification, but his followers came up with it. The first, Panya, means wisdom. Sila means ethical conduct or virtuous conduct. And Samadhi means concentration. As usually taught, the path begins with sila, ethical behavior, getting under control your bodily actions and your verbal actions so that you do not cause any hurt or harm to other beings. Then, Samadhi section is the training of the mind, and developing out of the mind training, there's the wisdom, Panya section. That is how, I think I might have mentioned last week, the symbolism of a stupa. You know, these buildings which you find dotted around Buddhist countries. The stupa or pagoda has three sections. I mentioned this to you last week? Or? Yeah, because you're looking rather puzzled, so I just want to make sure. Yeah. The base, the foundation is sila. On top of that, you can build samadhi, and developing from that is the pinnacle, Panya. But the way this Eightfold Path is presented, when you read about it, it starts off with Ditti, Sankappa, and then the others. The Buddha's teaching, he was once asked to summarize. And he summarized it in three simple sentences. cease to do evil, learn to do good, keep your mind pure. Doesn't sound very profound, but actually when you look into it in detail, it's a very, very profound teaching. But cease to do evil would be sila. Learn to do good, samadhi. Keep your mind pure,